Hi everyone and welcome back. In today's video, we are going to look at three HMI elements, the slider, bar and gauge, and see how to use them in a TIA Portal project. Whether you're just getting started or looking to sharpen your skills, this tutorial will walk you through the basics step by step. So let's get started. We're going to look at these elements, slider, bar, and gauge, which works similarly in this context. I'm going to start with the slider, drag and drop it into the project. With the slider, we can monitor and change process values within a defined range. This range is visualized in the format you see here. By adjusting the slider, we can change the process value. Click on the element and go to the properties. Let's say we want to show pressure. This will appear at the title here. The first thing we need is an HMI and PLC tag that holds the pressure value. I'm going to create a data block. And define a data type integer. Now we can drag this PLC variable directly here and the HMI tag will be created automatically. Or we can create it manually. Open HMI tags. Click Add New. Enter a name. Choose where to save this tag, either in the default tag table or create a new one here. Set the data type the same as the PLC variables type. Since we want the tag to communicate with our PLC, it should not be internal. Select the connection. The PLC name appears here. And then choose the PLC variable. Now we can use this HMI tag as the process tag for the slider. Let's start the simulation and see how the slider works. Download the PLC and monitor the value. The initial value is 0 and the slider shows 0 as well. As you can see, I'm able to change the pressure variable using the slider on the HMI panel. Next point, we can change the top and bottom end values of the slider. Enter values for maximum and minimum scale value. For example, 10 and 200. Start the simulation again. Now the minimum value is 10. Anything below 10 can't be set. And the maximum is 200. We can even set this range using tags, so the operator can adjust it directly from the HMI panel. Define two variables inside the data block. And use these as the tags for the maximum and minimum values. If you want the application to allow the operator to change these limits, just insert these tags onto the screen. Use a text element to indicate the range. I don't want to show the sign here. Download the changes. Everything is at zero, so nothing appears. Set the range and now we can use the slider to control and visualize the range dynamically through the HMI. Let's explore some other properties. Here we can change the appearance, change the layout, color, use an image as the background or for the slider. Adjust border, width, style, and color. Set size, position, and alignment. We can also choose whether to display the current value, the slider itself, and other options. Change the text format too. The next important section is limit range. We can display limits and range in different colors. This allows us to indicate operating state, such as normal, warning, or forbidden zones. To do this, activate show range from tag. You can define up to 5 ranges using process tags. As you can see, they all show as question marks for now. That means they are not defined yet. To define them, go to the HMI tags. Find your process tag in the tag table. and from the properties look for the range section. You can define range as constants or use tags. If using constants, just enter the values here. For example, upper 2 180, upper 1 150, lower 1 70, and lower 2 20. Go back to the HMI screen again and you will see the range applied visually. You can also customize the default colors for each range or enable and disable them. Let's test the changes. Set the minimum and maximum values. Now you won't be able to go below the lower two range, below 20. An alarm appears when you reach this lower limit. We can enter the second range, which is like a warning zone. And anything above 180, upper 2 is not allowed. So using ranges and limits, we can restrict the slider and indicate different process states. Here you can also enable flashing for the element. There are other options in the advanced level, but we don't need them for now. Next up are the bar and gauge elements. They are very similar to the slider, but unlike the slider, which allows input, the bar and gauge are output only. It means they simply display the variable's state. You cannot change it. Just like with the slider, assign the tag you want to display. The other properties are just like the slider. With the scale, we can change how the numbers are displayed and adjust their spacing. You can also display the value with a unit. Again, for the gauge, assign the process tag. You can define a title, a unit, and adjust the scale gradation. Start the simulation again. With the bar, the upper and lower limits are shown using limits markers, and in the gauge, they appear as green and red lines. So the main difference between the slider and the other two elements is that the slider lets you change the process value, but the bar and gauge only displays the value. Alright, that brings us to the end of another tutorial. In this video, we learn how to use three elements, slider, bar, and gauge in our HMI project to monitor and control process values. I hope you found it helpful and learned something new. If you have any questions or feedback, feel free to leave a comment. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.